Nikki Blonsky shot to fame playing Tracy Turnblad in Hairspray. Almost 15 years on, and the movie still remains one of the most popular film musicals of all time. Craig Bennett caught up with the star for a trip down memory lane.
Good morning, Baltimore. Every day's like an open door.
Nikki Blonsky, what fun to be zooming with you into Los Angeles.
Hi, it's so lovely to see you.
You know, when you think about movie debuts, when you think about those big Hollywood breaks, as they say, yours would probably have to go down in history as one of the most spectacular.
The new girl in town who just came on the scene.
You were working in the ice cream store and the phone call comes through and the look on your face.
They had told me that they wanted to do a behind the scenes with each of the four final girls, and for me, they wanted to come to Cold Stone to see me in my natural environment, so they came. A whole camera crew walked in, and they sat me down. They said, we would like for you to watch some of the other people's screen tests, and I said, sure. I sat down, and they opened up a laptop, and Adam Shankman popped up, the director who I had met at the dance auditions.
Hey, Nikki. I think that you should probably, you know, make yourself a big ice cream cone because it's you, honey. You got the part.
I was just, like, out of my body. I was like, no way! Like, I started crying, all the emotions. I fell on the floor. The next morning after prom, I woke up to calls from all these talent agencies and people wanting to do interviews. And my mom kind of was like Edna. She was like, what do I do? You know, who do we call?
Hey, mama, look around. Everybody's grooving to a brand new sound.
But I have to say for you, Nikki, to have the great John Travolta playing your mum, Edna.
Pinch me. It's more like taser me. Make sure, like, I was like, what?
I think perks like caftans have to be negotiated. Maybe we should get you an agent.
I saw an interview with you, Nikki, that was just beautiful, where you were very candid about the fact that agents would get in touch and say, we love you, you're so talented, you sing, you dance, you act. But gee, if you could just lose a little weight or whatever, you've been trolled. And John Travolta was like a guardian angel to you.
John's main advice to me from day one was always remain true to who you are. Always be Nikki. Don't let anybody change you or don't change for anybody.
Being so close to John as you became and loving him as clearly you do as a great friend, how did you come to wrap your head around that dreadful news last year that his wife of nearly 30 years, Kelly, had passed away?
Oh my gosh, I was heartbroken. Kelly and I shared so many wonderful memories, and I look back on them so fondly that I got to meet her, got to experience the beauty, the interior and the exterior beauty of Kelly Preston.
Some folks can't stand it, say time is a bandit, but I take the opposite view.
You had John Travolta as your mum. You had Christopher Walken, Oscar-winning legend, as your dad. I mean, talk about spoiled for choice. You must have been in showbiz nirvana.
He's just such an amazing actor, and he has an incredible way about him. He makes you feel incredibly safe in the scenes that you do with him. He was so gentle with me, and he really treated me like Tracy. Like, he was very paternal with me and very kind.
Nikki also worked alongside the fabulous Michelle Pfeiffer, Amanda Bynes, Queen Latifah, and of course a Hollywood heartthrob, the dreamy Zac Efron.
Zac is so incredibly fun, and he's got such a beautiful heart and soul.
And then, of course, Nikki, just between us, there was that kiss.
That was a kiss that lasted 9 days, and when I tell most women that, like, their jaw drops and I think they lose oxygen for a couple seconds. It's during such a big scene, and that filming, you can't stop the beat, was a 9-day thing. So Zach and I kind of, at that point, whenever there would be that angle, we had to stand there and kiss.
After Hairspray, Nikki worked steadily. We saw her on TV's Ugly Betty, which starred America Ferrera, and she had a great role in the 2017 drama The Last Movie Star, which turned out to be one of the last big screen gigs for the late, great Burt Reynolds.
We were just inseparable on set. He told me so many incredible stories about Patsy, about his time when he was friends with Dean Martin and Frank Sinatra and Sammy Davis and all the greats.
The veteran Hollywood actor Burt Reynolds has died at the age of 82.
When that news came through, Nikki, that he'd passed away, that I can see it in your eyes, that must have hit you so hard.
It was really hard, yeah. It was really tough.
Last year saw Nikki channeling Diana Ross's hit anthem, I'm Coming Out, to tell the world she's now out and proud. And it turned her into an inspiring media sensation. And Nikki tells me she's working on sharing her journey in a revealing book.
I have no idea when it's going to be finished. I have no idea when it'll be published. But I just know that writing has become something that I truly enjoy, and sharing my story, but also from my point of view, and really letting people hear it in my words is something that I really look forward to.
Nikki Blonsky, it has been a joy chatting with you. I knew you were absolute pure sunshine. You have not disappointed. In fact, I've got a little, I should have worn an SPF 30 chatting to you. That's how much sunshine you are.
Oh my gosh, you're so sweet. 'Cause you can't stop.